Where's your first review this week?
My first review is going to be a film you've reviewed. It's going to be Fantastic Four. It's a pile of bollocks.
Yes!
That film was absolute fucking shite.
It was amazing, right?
It was shit.
It was really good.
It, like, 20 minutes at the start, I'm like, oh, this is alright. It doesn't feel like Fantastic Four, but it's alright.
Do you play my drinking game?
No.
My drinking game is every time you notice Kate Mara's wearing a wig, you take a shot.
Well, that's all in the second half of the film, because it's, like, quite clearly been reshot. But it's so shit. Like, they have this whole setup with Ben Grimm and Reed Richards that they never call themselves by the Fantastic. Ben Grimm doesn't even want to say they've turned me into a thing. Like, you could have just done that. No, like, they have this whole build up and then they get called to the center. Ben doesn't get to go. He lives in New York. He's come with Reed to New York, but he doesn't work at the center. He just stays at home. So have they got a thing going on?
What, like bumming?
I don't think him and Sue are getting together. But then they have this whole bit where, like, Sue Storm's job is to make costumes because women make clothes.
Which is in the second half.
No, she doesn't make the super suits, though. Someone else does. She doesn't have anything to do with that.
Oh, yeah, she makes the adaptive
suits. She makes the environment suits.
Yeah, but she is a biologist.
But this is like, she doesn't have anything to do that. But then there's that whole bit where they get drunk and they go, oh, we're going to go through the portal thing. Wait, we're not all here. And they call Ben Grimm. He had nothing to do with building
thing.
His job when they were at school was finding, like, copper wire and shit. Like, he didn't even understand the stuff they were making. Like, couldn't they have, like, here's how you could have worked him in. Like, you know they said NASA were going to come in and go through the portal?
Yep.
Why not have Ben Grimm be a member of NASA? He's an astronaut in the comics. He was there. Why not have it be, oh, I've got a scholarship, I'm going to join NASA. Set the whole bit where they want to do the portal and they make the experiment a couple of years later. Yeah, but they're not teen at that point, are they?
They're meant to be like 20.
Yeah, but you can say that it's gone like 2 years later and Ben Grimm's done NASA. They've gone their separate ways. And then he comes back and he's like, oh, they want me to go through here.
Yeah.
And he's like, you know what, this was your dream, Reed. Let's all do this now. And let's take Sue because she made those suits and they fit quite nice. And he's like,
she's got a measurement.
Sue, could you make me some shorts? That'd be nice, but she doesn't make him any shorts. Ben Grimm has to walk around naked.
He's super naked. He's got no penis.
No.
Do you think he's like a dog?
He should have made that.
Do you think he just like...
just pops out.
Yeah, it's like
just a really fleshy with spikes. It's like an echidna one, eight
it's
tips.
Like seven.
Got eight tips on it, like an echidna.
It's like seven. You made me fuck up.
Yeah.
No one believes you, rock monster. You're coming downtown,
kid. Ben Grimm's blind girlfriend.
Oh, she's lovely.
She's not in it.
I know.
No. The film's embarrassed to be a Fantastic Four movie. It's embarrassed to be a comic book movie.
No.
Why does the Human Torch have to switch his powers on and off with a button?
Okay. Wait, does he?
Yeah. His suit has a control. He can't stop his flames. He has to turn a switch. They actually specify that the suit allows him to control his power.
Oh, yeah, I don't remember that.
So whenever you see him land, he goes... poof, like that, and it's like a gas valve thing that he turns off. Sue Storm's suit can go invisible, though. That's no trouble. She doesn't need to switch that on or off. Nah, that's fine. Reed Richards makes his own stretchy suit out of just really long sleeves and some friggin' slinkies.
No, he has springs.
He gets a slinky suit.
Yeah, he has a special slinky suit.
He escapes and then disappears, and then Doctor Doom turns up, and he's like, oh, Doctor Doom's really injured. Then he gets in the thing, and he's like, oh, you woke me up. I'm going to destroy the world now. Sorry.
Yeah.
That's my plan all along. So when did that come into it? This is 20 minutes from the end.
Okay. So, what do you give...
And then they got the most half-assed, if we work as a team, we can save the day bit.
What do you give the Fantastic Four as it exists now?
Fuck all, that film's shit.
But, here's the question. Even though you've seen this, do you not
want... It's not even campy.
Do you want to see the original film?
Well, the Josh Trank one. It'll probably still be terrible.
You reckon?
Yeah, I reckon.
See, because I like... Okay, so this is...
I don't think he had any intention of making a Fantastic Four film.
This is my argument, right? I like Michael B. Jordan. I like, God, what was the guy who played Von...
Toby Kebbell.
Toby Kebbell. I like both those actors
Kibbles
a lot.
Kibbles and Bits.
They're both quite Kebbles funny. And even in this, like, the small moments of characterization you get from both of those
You
people,
know Toby Kebbell's, Doc Doom's of Gamergator in this, man.
Yeah, he does.
That's what he is. He's like, I hate the world, I want to see it burn.
Well, no, that's the thing. He's that bearded, neck-bearded personality that we take the piss out of.
I don't want Doctor Doom. I want Doctor Doom in a film. Just but once. I want Doctor
I
Doom
do
to
well.
Be in a film.
And we can have Doctor Doom. I kind of think that Josh Trank was like, okay, so they go into this world, Doctor Doom...
Couldn't they have cut back to him and shown how he's evolved over the years?
Well, that's the thing. The whole of the thing where he fell in the stuff and then never came back.
Why did he touch it?
It seems like that was shot after Josh Trank left.
And what's with... They put the flag in the earth, the ground cracks. 20 seconds later, they stick a pike into the earth so they can abseil down a cliff. You've just seen that the ground does not like having stuff stuck in it.
That whole... like,
they get their powers based on what stuff is hitting them in the face when they get in the pod.
This is the thing that I really, really didn't like. Did you not feel like... you know, so as soon as they're getting drunk and he's bouncing on the chair and they're being a little bit childish,
yeah,
and you're kind of like, this is getting a bit campy. This is getting a bit towards, like, teenagers have been given in unlimited power. What are they doing? But as soon as they go into that thing, I'm like, someone else is filming this.
Well, Josh Trank apparently shot all the extra bits, but it was all just based on studio, what they wanted. And he was like, okay, but as long as I can shoot it. So at least then it retains some of his visual style.
Because all that stuff in that other, all the CGI stuff in the other planet felt weird. It felt different. Yeah.
But it's like, we're scientists. Let's go dig our hands in this green goo.
Like, and then even when they came back, the only part that felt like Josh Trank had filmed it was the part where Miles Teller was screaming out for someone to come help him.
I can see the Cronenberg influences there and all that.
Like,
but
and then where he's crawling through the vents and you just see a pile of rocks. So I was like, okay, again, this feels like a horror film.
I'm going to come back for you, Ben. I'll come back. He spends a year.
Yeah, takes this feels a year. Like more like what Josh Trank was trying to go
he
for.
He doesn't
in the
even
first
come
half.
Back for them. Like, they capture him.
He gets caught.
He gets headbutted in the forest in a 12-second action. Your one action scene.
There is so much in that film that feels like someone else is filming it. Mm. And then it goes back to something that feels familiar to the first part.
And then the film fucking cuts before they even say Fantastic Four. Yeah. Like, how it, like, the whole film, the whole way through, I'm like, are you embarrassed to be a comic book movie?
I want to see Josh Trank's version.
This looks fantastic. What did you say?
If I don't get to see Josh Trank's version, I would just like to read.
If the film was successful, you might have had a chance of seeing Josh Trank's version because they think, oh, we could re-release this, get some more money out of it. But it wasn't.
I'd like to read Max Landis's.
This is going to be like the Richard Donner cut, except no one wants to see Josh Trank's version of the film.
I do! I really do! That's the problem. I have this...
Richard Donner cut of Superman 2 is actually really good.
No, it's not.
It's like
fantasy.
It's a cobbled together thing because of all the mess that's gone on, but there's better stuff in it.
Did Mario Kidder cut his face off and wear it for a week on set?
But, Fantastic Four Spot, it's given me a new appreciation for the friggin' Tim Story films.
No, it's not.
No, because there's little things like, we just made suits that work in this one. But in the Tim Story one, it's like, at least they tried to explain it was part of the Power Cosmic. It felt like a comic book movie.
I think this could have been something. I think there could have been something good in there, and I think it's fucking gone.
Not Fantastic Four, though. It should be something else.
It could have been Fantastic Four, but it would have been Fantastic Four matching The Amazing Spider-Man. If you match those together, if you were to think of those universes as one, because they're trying to do the ultimate universe.
Bollocks as well.
I know, but they're trying to do the ultimate universe, but they just don't know what that means.
No.
And that's fine, because the ultimate universe was, I reckon if you were a 50-year-old man and you were given a comic and someone went, oh, it looks edgy. You know, there's blood. There's a little bit of swearing. Let's make edgy Spider-Man. Let's make edgy fantasy. It's like, no.
Oh, Spider-Man went to shit off the boy Michael Bendis stopped writing it.
No, it didn't.
It did.
No, it didn't, because you've still got fucking Miles Morales, one of the best Spider-Men. Like, even with Spider-Gwen, Venom, you know, all those other people taking over the Spider-Man mantle, the best Spider-Man is still Peter Parker in Ultimate Spider-Man or Miles...
Everyone knows the best Spider-Man Miles is Morales. Peter Parker in the 1990s cartoon.
No.
Everyone knows it is. That's the best Spider-Man.
That voice is fucking irritating.
And there's that whole episode of Spider-Man, there's a bit where Venom's driving a truck, and he's like, beep, beep, Spider-Man! I watched the first Spider-Man film the other day, Sam Raimi one.
Yeah,
still fucking good.
It's great.
I was going to watch Spider-Man 2, but Avengers Age of Ultron was on at the same time. I'm like, is that on TV? And my uncle was like, there's a new Avengers film? I'm like, yeah, switching over, going to watch Age of Ultron.
Oh, on Sky Movies?
Yeah, and I was like quite surprised, and it's still not a great film. But
I still think Ultron and Black Widow are the best things about that film.
Yeah. Oh, and the bit where Quicksilver grabs Thor's hammer as he's running past it. It's fucking hilarious.
Yeah. And Vision. Vision's really good.
Hmm.
I mean, like, the problem is too much Tony Stark. It'll kill you every time.
Yeah.
Captain America's loosely defined powers. Why is it only the Russo brothers can get his powers right?
Yeah.
I'm really looking forward to Civil War.
Yeah. 3 months away.
No, no.
We got to get through Batman Deadpool versus first. Superman first.
Fuck you!
Anyway, Fantastic Four is
Batman
bollocks.
Batman versus Superman. Gods and monsters.